men are from Mars and women are from Venus. But do you know why we're so different? It stems from our childhood and stretches through our adult lives. It's our purpose, our body language, and our willingness to be vulnerable. So in a nutshell, it's the way we communicate. From childhood, women use conversation to build relationships. If you've ever heard of a group of girls get together, you know what I'm talking about. Oh, Sophie, your top is so cute. Oh, thanks, I love your dress. Where'd you get it? And blah, 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 half an hour has passed, and it doesn't seem like they've talked about anything important. But that's how women build relationships. They give each other compliments. They're nice to each other. They want to talk. And, of course, there are exceptions, but according to an article by Dr. Susan Sherwood and my own personal experience, that's just what girls do. For that reason, a lot of women avoid confrontation until it's absolutely necessary. They don't want to appear upfront and demanding. Most men, on the other hand, would rather do something than bond through simple chatter. Little boys use activities such as sports to make friends and to build relationships. That's why it's easier for them to do than it is for most girls. So as said in a thesis paper written by, it was written for a university by Karina Merchant, as well as endless online sources, I found so many, men also use conversation to show their status and maintain their independence. These habits continue as boys grow older and can result in problems when they try to communicate and even understand the opposite gender. They grow up being dominated by purpose. If they have a conversation with a woman that doesn't seem to have much of a point, they won't consider it very valuable. The woman, on the other hand, probably did have a point to build a relationship and to get closer to him. Take Bob and Shelley, for example. They just started dating last night when I made them. And they're really hitting it off. They're out to dinner, and while they're waiting for their food, Bob has been bragging about his multiple touchdowns in football. He's been having a really good season, and he loves talking about himself, so it's a win-win for Bob. This, according to multiple blogs and articles, including one by relationship therapist Richard Dromnick, who is head of the Mars and Venus Counseling Center, is a way for him to show superiority and skill. So yeah, I tackled that guy and that guy, and I'm really manly. Shelley is impressed with him. She likes that he's telling her about his personal life. Well, that's great, Bob. Thanks. What other things do you like? It seems to Bob that the conversation has been going really well, but he doesn't want to seem like he's talking too much. He decides he wants to learn more about her. But suddenly the waiter comes with their food, so they engage in a little small talk while they start to eat, and Shelley, who's a little sick of listening to Bob yap all night, says something about how she hates chicken because she owned some when she was a little girl, and she had a little chick named Mary, who was just the cutest. A week later, Shelley mentions Mary, and Bob is confused because he doesn't know any Mary. Shelley's offended because she doesn't think Bob is a very good listener. She keeps it to herself, though. They haven't been dating that long, and she doesn't want to scare him off. But later, they're deciding what movie to watch, and Bob, who couldn't care less what they watch, just wants to get it over with and decide. Little does he know, Shelley's already mad at him, and his apparent lack of interest isn't helping. So, Bob, which movie will it be? You choose. I chose last time. You choose. All right, I want to watch blah, blah. I heard it's not very good. Okay, but we can watch it if you want to. Okay. You want to? Okay. You know what, Bob? You can go to the movies by yourself today. Bob had no idea they were even in an argument, and now he has no excuse to get out of dinner with his family. Thanks, Shelley. Good going. He doesn't understand that women don't argue the same way as men do. They use questions, and most of the time, they're a little less direct about what they want. If men have a problem with you, they're much more likely to talk to you straight out to your face. Maybe it's an attempt to give you advice on what they're doing wrong, what you're doing wrong, which is yet another way to assert their dominance. But they'll say it with a bluntness that a lot of women don't resort to unless they're very angry. So I've only touched on the tip of the iceberg. I learned way more about it than I talk about, and there's way more about it than I've learned. But I hope you can remember when talking to coworkers, siblings, teachers, and anybody of the opposite gender, that a lot of your arguments stem from simply having different styles of communication. It's certainly not worth ending a relationship, any sort of relationship.